Hello and welcome to the Australian Youth Orchestra's Autumn Music Camp performance. Autumn Music Camp draws its inspiration from the great tradition of National Music Camp. And this year we're delighted to be partnering with the Melbourne Conservatorium of Music here at the University of Melbourne. For the past week, more than 150 young musicians, orchestral managers and sound recordists have been working intensively with their tutors and conductors. We're now going to hear from the Alexander Orchestra with their conductor, Fabian Russell. I hope you enjoy the performance.
Thank you. My name is Fabian Russell and I am one of the two guest conductors conducting at this year's 2021 National Music Camp, Autumn Music Camp in fact. I have had a long association with the Australian Youth Orchestra now going back nearly 30 years when I was engaged as a brass tutor at the 1992 National Music Camp, which was held in Geelong. And since then, I have had the great good fortune of being invited back several times to a camp as a tutor many years ago, and probably on half a dozen occasions. And then the first time I conducted at a National Music Camp in Adelaide in 2013. And over the years, I've also had many great experiences as the associate conductor of the Australian Youth Orchestra, preparing the orchestra for many of the guest conductors that come to work with us. When I travel overseas, there's been many times I've met colleagues throughout Europe and America, and when the name Australian Youth Orchestra comes up, they know well and truly that this is a terrific organisation. I hear many compliments from colleagues abroad. I'm always very proud to hear those sort of things. It's something that we should all be tremendously proud of. It's had such a long and distinguished history, and so many of our great Australian musicians who benefited by when they were children themselves, just youngsters, people in their early 20s, and had that initial training, and it gave them that spark of the possibilities of what it could be like actually to make great music with terrific people. And to be a part of that, it's a real privilege and an honour, in fact, to be invited back to conduct it again with this great organisation. So the repertoire that we are playing was specifically selected to train these musicians and give them exposure to works that they quite often don't have access to. I always, if I program La Valse, I almost always pair it with the Prelude to the Afternoon of a Faune by Debussy. I think these are two of the landmark French works, and to put them both on the same program, it gives young musicians who have not played them before a great start in coming to terms with very, very difficult music. It's really well worth it. Very exciting, very beautiful, and I can't think of two French works that are more beautiful than either of those two. Well, this has been one continuous gradient of improvement. From the very first rehearsal, I mean, I know what happens in first rehearsals with youth orchestras. Everyone's very, very excited and they just get in there and they just tear into the piece. And the great thing about these people is that every rehearsal we have, it goes to the next level, each and every time. And now at the 7-day mark, some of the moments in the Ravel were just spectacular. At times I thought, well, this pretty much sounds like a professional orchestra. And they've done that in a week. Shostakovich is a composer that young musicians love. They can relate to it. They love the drama of it, the excitement, the energy. And the First Symphony was a work that Shostakovich wrote when he was 17 years of age, younger than any of the participants in this camp. And I think that's really inspirational for a young musician to be playing something by somebody of their age. It doesn't play itself. It's a difficult work. There's lots of quirky episodes in the first two movements. It's quite light-hearted at times and lots of fun, but we get to the third movement and it's all of a sudden the maturity of the composer, it's awe-inspiring. It's incredibly beautiful music that someone so young was able to, in his own imagination, in his sleep, come up with such a gorgeous work of art. Thank you for listening today. We hope when we're back to live audiences that you come to the next performance of the Australian Youth Orchestra. You won't be disappointed.
I am the orchestra management tutor on camp this year. I've been really blessed with some amazing students who have been working incredibly hard to get the instrumental students on stage for all of our concerts. Each day we've been going through a specific area of orchestra management. We've talked about marketing, we've talked about artistic planning, sponsorship, education, and then around that we've been managing and helping out the instrumental students with making sure all their instruments and music are in the right place at the right time and preparing them for the concerts.
Hi, I'm Grace.
And I'm Carissa.
And we're sat here creating the run sheet for tonight's chamber concert.
The run sheet provides all the tiny details that will allow this concert to run smoothly.
Hi, I'm Stella.
And I'm Jess.
And here we have our wonderful wall of stage plans for our chamber music concert tonight. So, for example, this is what a string quartet looks like on a stage plan. So we've got violin here, two violins, a double bass and a cello. Yeah.
And then here, this is an example of a quintet. And so this follows this one. And to get to this one, we have to strike all of the chairs, take them off stage, because this group will be standing, and then we have to shuffle it into a quintet formation.
So we're going to shuffle some things on stage now.
So this is backstage at Hanson Dye Hall. As you can see, we're nice and set up for percussion ensemble, who are on first tonight for the chamber music concert. And we've just got a couple of timpanis that need to come in across from another space.
Let's do it. Anita, welcome to Prompt Corner. This is where the stage manager sits in order to call the show. So one of the very important things right at the start of the show is to make sure that the stage manager will get clearance from front of house so that we know that the audience is ready to see the show, but then I'll also wait for clearance from the orchestra manager so that then I know the orchestra is ready to go. So I've actually received clearance from front of house and the orchestra manager, which means it's time for the show.
Thank you. We've had a great week of music making, and playing with all of our friends again has been an absolutely extraordinary experience, and it's something that I know I won't take for granted again.
It's definitely something I've missed, feeling the adrenaline rush after a concert, or even, you know, sitting on stage.
Working with Fabian has been an absolute pleasure and an absolute joy. I feel that he was very meticulous and he didn't let us go with anything. He was very hard on us, and I really enjoyed it actually, because I think the final result was very great. His choice of repertoire, even with the Ravel, Debussy and Shostakovich, all of those three pieces just hold such a special place in my heart now. And he's really set us up well, I think.
Yeah, Fabian's a fantastic conductor. Going from, you know, the first downbeat on what would have been Sunday night a week ago to the concert that we just did. Yeah, there was, you know, an extraordinary amount of improvement made over the course of the week.
Having so many other musicians who are doing exactly the same thing you are is so inspiring. And watching the chamber, both chamber music concerts, and getting to see everyone perform was absolutely amazing. And I've learned so much just from watching my peers play.
I think my favourite memory, or at least one of the more peculiar ones, would just be sitting down in a room again with, what, 80 other people? I just thought to myself, wow, this is such a pleasure, this is such a blessing to be able to do again. Especially when in places around the world they're not able to do such things yet. So that was, a highlight, just even playing that tuning note with other people.